moment of inertia of a flywheel. The aim of our experiment is to determine the moment of inertia of the given flywheel. We are provided with a flywheel apparatus. The flywheel consists of a heavy wheel W, which is mounted on a rigid support with the help of an axle, and the axle is provided with a small peg, and we are provided with a long cord. One end of the cord can be wound over the axle passing through the peg, and the other end of the cord we can suspend our masses. Coming to the principle of our experiment, moment of inertia of the flywheel is calculated using the formula I is equal to m n2 divided by n1 plus n2 2gh divided by omega square minus r square. Now we will explain each terms. Here m is the mass that we are suspending on the cord or one end of the cord, and n1 and n2. N1 means we mentioned the cord can wound over the axle. So n1 is the number of times or the number of turns where the cord is wound over the axle. It can be 5 or 6 like that. Then n2 means after suspending a mass m, we are releasing the flywheel. Then the cord wound over the axle unwinded and it releases from the axle. Then at that time we are starting to count how many times the wheel is rotating. So the wheel is going on rotating. So it performs a certain number of rotations n2 before coming to rest. So n2 is the number of rotations of the wheel before coming to rest after detaching the mass from the axle. Then for this n2 rotations, it takes a certain time t. So t is the time for n2 rotations. From that we are calculating the value of omega. We can calculate 4 pi n2 by t, that is omega value. Then here g is the gravity and h is the height of the mass that we suspended from the ground, that is h, and r is the radius of the axle. Then we can see omega is calculated 4 pi n2 by t. In the procedure part, now this is the flywheel arrangement. This is the heavy wheel W. It is fixed over the axle, that is supported on two rigid supports. Now the cord is wound over the axle n1 times. Now a mass m is suspended on the other end. The mass is at a height h from the ground. Then after arrangement, this one is released, the wheel is released. Then the mass is moving down. Then it is released from the axle. Then the wheel starts rotating. Now initially we are taking a particular mass m is suspended, and n1 is noted. How many times the cord is wound over the axle is counted, that is n1. Then h is measured. Then when it is released, we are counting the time with the help of a stopwatch. The number of rotations and the time taken t are determined. Then from that we can calculate the value of 4 pi n2 by t, and the moment of inertia can be calculated because we all obtain all the values. Now coming to the table column, we mentioned we are suspending a certain mass. Say we suspended a mass of say 200 gram. Say n1 is equal to 5 or 6. H is measured, that is from the ground it is measured. Now the number of rotation we can see, two times we are determined. That means initially we perform the experiment. Then for the same value of mass and same number of turns, we repeat the experiment once again, that is 2. Then mean n2 is calculated. Then time for both the two times, first time and second time, time is calculated, mean t is calculated, then omega is calculated, 4 pi n2 by t. From that we can calculate the value of moment of inertia I. Now the experiment is repeated for another value of mass. Let's say we can take the same value of number of turns or a different value. Then each time h is measured and the readings are taken, number of rotation n2 and the time t are determined using the stop clock. Then the moment of inertia I is calculated. So this is the table column to find the diameter of the axle or the radius. So mean square reading, mean square reading and total we have noted. Then the diameter we obtained. Then we obtained the result, moment of inertia of the flywheel. This is our apparatus flywheel. The flywheel can stop a heavy wheel W. Now this wheel is supported on an axle. This is the axle, and this axle is supported on two bar with the help of ball bearings, and this wheel can be rotated. The wheel can be rotated, and here we are using a long cord. A long cord is here. One end of the long cord, we are suspending a mass. So here we are suspending 500 grams. So the total mass suspended is 200 grams or 0.2 kilogram. And the other end of the cord is passing with the help of a small nail. Inside a peg here, it is passing here. Then, for the experiment, we are having N1. N1 means the number of rotations of the cord on the axle. So we are winding it. Now it is rotated. Now it is completed one rotation. Then again it is rotated, say 2. Again it is rotated, say 3. Again it is rotated, say 4. Again it is rotated, say 5. So here I am having N1. The number of turns of the cord on the axle is 5. And the suspended mass is 200 gram or 0.2 kilogram. Now we can measure the height of the weight from the bottom of the ground, to the bottom of the weight. To the bottom of the weight we can measure. Now I am obtaining a length of 39 centimeter. That means height from the bottom of the weight to the ground, that height is 39 centimeter, and that is H. Now we are starting our experiment. We are ready with the stopwatch here. Now we are releasing the wheel. The wheel is going to release. You can observe that when the wheel is released, it starts rotating. When the peg or the cord releases from the axle, we start the stopwatch. Then we have to count how many times the wheel is rotating. We have to take the number of rotations, at the same time the time also. So we are starting. The wheel is released. Now the wheel is released. We are ready with the stopwatch. When it releases, we start the stopwatch. We are counting 2, 3, 4 rotation, 5 rotation, 6 rotation, 7 rotation, 8 rotation, 9 rotation, 10 rotation, and almost 11. So we are getting 11 rotations. That is not completed. Even then, nearly completed. So we are taking 11 rotations, and we obtain the time as 20 seconds. So we obtain the number of rotations N2 and the time. Now for the same load and for the same number of times, we are repeating it once again. So the number of times again 5, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we are having the same mass. We can measure the height again. Maybe the same height we are getting X. Number of times should be 5 itself. Again we are releasing this wheel. The wheel is releasing as before. Then the cord is removed. We can start the stopwatch. So we can start and we can count. You count the number of times and number of rotations and also the time. Now in order to repeat this experiment, as we mentioned, we can add more weights. Now one more 50 gram is added. Now it is 250 gram or 0.25 kilogram. We can change the number of times also. So initially we are taking 5 itself. So 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 or 4, 5 and 6 we are repeating. We are repeating the experiment for 5 and 6. Similarly for more weights. More weights means adding one more weight, 300 gram. Again, if you are adding one more weight, 350. That means for different weights and for different number of times, we are repeating
and each time we are determining value of mu and t. So omega is calculated and the moment of inertia I is calculated. Now with the help of a vernier calipers, we can find the diameter of this axial we have to measure. So for that, we are measuring the diameter of the axial here. Now we can observe the MSR reading, that is about 2.2, I can note it, and the VSR reading here, it is 2. So it is repeated at different points from the axial. On either side of the axial, we can repeat, and we can find the diameter of the axial and hence the radius of the axial. So that's about the flywheel apparatus and how we are taking the readings with the help of a flywheel.
Now we come to a sample set of reading. The first tabular column is for the mass that we use. The second one is the number of turns. And the third column is h, the height of the mass from the ground. And then the number of rotations n2 performed. It is, we are doing it 2 times and the mean is calculated. Then the time for that n2 rotation, that is also 2 times. The mean time is calculated. Then omega and moment of inertia. So initially we suspend a mass of 200 gram or 0.2 kilogram. Then the number of turns is taken 5. Then height is measured from the ground as 0.39 or 39 centimeter. Then we obtain the number of rotations performed is 18, first time. In that case, the time obtained for that number of turns is 29. So 29 second is the time taken for this 18 rotations. That is the time taken by the wheel for performing 18 rotations and it comes to rest. Then the same experiment, the same set is repeated. That means for the same mass and for the same number of turns, the experiment is repeated once again. In that case, we obtain the number of rotations as 17 and the corresponding time is 31. So the mean value of n is 18 and 17, that is 17.5. And the mean value of n2 is 29 and 31, that is 30. Then we are calculating the value of omega, that is 4 pi n2 by t. Omega can be calculated. Now knowing the value of omega, substituting it in our equation for moment of inertia, we can calculate the moment of inertia and the moment of inertia is calculated as 0.0221. Now the experiment is repeated for the same mass, but the number of turns is changed to 6. And h is changed, it becomes 47 centimeter, 0.47 meter. So the number of rotations n2, first time that is 20, the corresponding time is 34. When it is repeated, the number of rotations is again 20, the time is 34. So the mean value of n and the mean value of t is determined, omega determined and I determined. So the experiment is repeated for a mass of 0.25, two different turns, 5 and 6. Another mass, 300 gram, number of turns 5 and 6. 350 gram, number of turns 5 and 6. In each time, we can calculate the moment of inertia. So here we calculate the moment of inertia 8 times. And the mean value of moment of inertia we obtain 0.0228. Now with the help of a vernier caliper, the diameter and hence the radius of the axial over which the wheel is attached is determined. So the main scale reading is noted, vernier scale reading is noted, the total that we obtain the diameter and the mean diameter. From that we are getting the radius value and we require this radius value for the moment of inertia calculations and finally we obtain the result. The moment of inertia I is equal to 0.0228. So that is about the experiment, flywheel, the determination of moment of inertia of a flywheel.